I believe that we can all agree that the whole copyrighted music debacle is a problem. Whether it's DMCA takedowns or content ID claims, it's super annoying. We've been fighting in order to be able to play just any song in our live streams or YouTube videos, but in the meantime, since the laws don't change, we've been trying to find solutions, and we've honestly found a couple of them. Right now, on the internet, there are so many websites and services that allows you to play copyright-free music or licensed music, if you will. And I'm definitely not teaching you anything by saying that, but there are two little problems with the services that are out there. One of them being that the music that you play through those services is not endless. If you go with a service for live streamers, for example, you'll have a bunch of tracks from a lot of genres, but they're still limited. You're probably wondering where I'm going with this. The second problem, which is something you may not have even thought about, but it's originality. If you go on a platform that has, you know, a limited amount of music that you can choose and you find your favorite one, anyone else can go there and find that same song and be like, hey, that's my favorite one. Because the whole point of having your own jingle is for people to associate that song with you. Now, all it takes is for a bigger creator to go ahead and use that song, and then forever you'll have people in your comments saying, hey, you stole that song from that person. Now there is a third problem, and the third problem is the length of the music. As a YouTuber, I make videos that can go from 1 minute all the way up to 30, even I have videos that are an hour, and you have no idea how much time I spend looking for 5 minute songs that I can piece together in order to create something that lasts an hour. Okay, I know this is the point where you start getting curious about what solution can you possibly find to all those problems. Custom music, right? Yes, but listen up. Today we're gonna be looking at a website called Mubert. And no, it's not like Fiverr where you can commission song by song. It is a website that uses AI to generate the perfect song for you. Let me stop talking about it and let me show you Mubert.com, which this video is sponsored by. Now, when they first reached out to me and they told me, hey, Mubert can render original royalty-free content, I thought this must be super time consuming. This must take a lot of time. I don't feel like creating my own music for my YouTube channel, for example, and definitely not creating track by track music for my live stream. That doesn't sound good, right? But I was wrong, because not only it's super fast, right here, exactly here, you can go genre, moods, activities, depending on what you're doing, basically. Genre of music, here you have liquid funk, you have psy chill, everything. Ambient, dark ambient, glitch hop, witch house. I didn't know witch house was a thing. But of course, everyone's favorite category, chill, right? And then duration. If you want it to last 45 seconds, you can do that. Or we can make it, let's say 1 minute 45 seconds. But for my tutorials, I would probably put something like 30 minutes. Before we generate the track, a quick look at the website. They'll tell you everything about, hey, no more legal threats, DMCA takedowns, of course, start generating music for free. Yes, you can generate the music for free. You can even hear what other people have used the website to create here. All right, but all the free stuff, it has a watermark on it, so you can't steal it. All right, you do have to pay to remove the watermark, but you can even download your tracks with the watermark if you want to. Pause. Editing guide level here. I know I said that you could download the songs with a watermark. This is actually not true. You can download the songs and use them without a watermark with the free version. So I'm here and I just logged in with an email account. And what I can do is click download. It will tell me bottom left that it's been added to my downloads. Then I click on my profile picture, then my downloads, and I can see them here and I can download them. It will tell me, hey, this is what you need to do in order to give us credit. And then you can just agree and download. That simple. Boom. Here it is. And here's the contract. So you only need a premium account if you want a different license to the songs that you created. Back to you, future me, or past me, actually. And this is kind of like the best explanation here, is that they work with artists that provide samples and loops. And then the AI takes over and mix matches all of that to create your own music. That is what is cool. You can even become an artist here if you want to work with Mubert. And then at the bottom here, they answer a bunch of questions. You will also realize that there's multiple licenses that you can buy depending on what you want to do with the track, probably like commercial licensing, or if you want to own the full copyright to the original track, you can do that too. But let's go back up and generate a song. So remember, we picked by genre, and then the genre was chill, and then duration was 1 minute 45 seconds, right? Which is a pretty short song. And click make a track now. Now it brings us to the render part. Basically, they offer us what is already created. So if I'm just looking for music that are chill, that are kind of like in the same realm, they're already here. But again, genre, we want chill, boom, and we want 1 minute 45. And click generate track. It already has a song that is similar to the link. Well, not similar, it's exactly 1 minute 45. That is Chill Vaporwave. But in the meantime, it is generating our song. And there you go. In a couple of seconds, it just made it, probably because the song was super short. But still, I'm gonna make sure that you can hear it and then we'll play it. All right, let's go. Okay.
Mubert.
Yo, this is a bop, actually. What? Let's skip to the ending and see how it... Well, we can even see at the bottom here, there's like a break, and then it picks back up, and then that's the ending, right? Let's check it out. All right. So that's the break here. We don't have the kick anymore. We still have the hi-hats, the snare, no bass. And it's gonna pick back up. Oh, we have some. Ooh, okay. All right, so the ending. Oh, that's just the bass with the kick. We have some pads in the background. All right, let's skip. Let's create something else. What do you think? Well, let's not create by genre this time. Let's create by moods. Actually, let me show you the moods that you have, right? Fun, beautiful, friends, gentle, inspirational, peaceful, Valentine's, acoustic, calm, acoustic. All right. Acoustic song that lasts 2 minutes, not 20 minutes. There you go. 2 minutes, acoustic, generate track. So see, it basically saves it. So if I want to download this, I can do that while it's creating my other track. This track that was similar to the one that I asked. I need to listen to it. You never know. Okay.
Mubert.
Ah, that one's kind of weird. Mostly get a fade out. I wonder if everything is a fade out. Anyways, let's click on moods, calm, acoustic. So we got some strings, we got some guitar. They also, by the way, if you want to pick like the key that it's in, it tells you here. You have like an A sharp, like this one was G sharp, F sharp. The BPM, if you want to go in details on how you want your song to sound exactly, you can do that. Not a big fan of the acoustic there. Extreme, energizing, groovy. Okay, I'm always up for groovy. Let's go. And while it's creating this, let me go to activities and see what are the options. So, beautiful, meditation, om, zen, chill out, ethnic, 108, romantic, summer, travel. Okay, there's focus, there's game, battle, fantasy, sci-fi. This is something that I would definitely use, especially like if you're doing one of those action intros, that could be cool. All right, moods, energizing, groovy. Let's check it out. Got a lot of piano coming up.
Mubert.
I like this. Okay. What? Come on, give me the drop.
Mubert.
Anyway, so activities, let's pick a battle, right? 2 minutes. Actually, let's go 1 minute here. Boom. There you go. Keeping in mind, like, this is not supposed to be, you know, songs that you play for a friend. It's like, I would say background music, if you will. So game setting, battle. What do you have for me?
Mubert.
This is pretty dope. Okay, that's nice. Okay, now here's the thing. This is just me generating song by song. If I'm creating like a YouTube channel for intro, outro, if you have a VR back scene or a set intro for your stream, maybe you can use that. But if you're a live streamer, you most likely are looking for a solution to just play music during the whole thing without thinking about it, right? So if you go back, well, we have to go back and find products. There we go, products. And then here we will find Moobird for streamers. And you click on this, and this is where you find those AI stations. I believe they are AI stations, but basically it is AI generated music for a live stream. And all you have to do is basically manage them directly through your broadcasting software. So you can see here, you can copy the URL, and what's going to do is add them to OBS Studio as your browser source, and it will be playing music. It will appear in your mixer so you can check the volume and stuff like that. Let's copy it here and let's see what it would be like in my browser instead of adding it to OBS, because I'm using OBS to play it. So there it is. Which one did we choose? Ambient. Okay, so this is calm ambient. But as you can see, they categorize them by what you're doing. If you're just chatting, for example, you want certain stuff. If you're playing games, if you're talking, but it's like educational or serious. And if you're just web, I like, what is this, 18 plus webcam? They have a thing for that. Hardest BDSM techno. Erotic lounge. Under let's play, you have hard underground techno, you have space ambient, you have lo-fi station. Let's check this one out. I'm gonna add one to OBS to see what it looks like. And again, I believe those play like forever basically, which is so cool. If you read DMCA stage, music station for live streams, compatible with YouTube, Facebook, Twitch, and there's no issues there. It's all generated, I think. I think it's also great if you're doing like a conference or anything really. It's just background music for anything that you want. You just need to pick whatever you want and then you're good. Hey, Future Guy Level here. In order to add it to OBS and make it work, you have to add it as a browser source, of course. So you copy paste the link here, but you also need to click control audio via OBS. Otherwise, it's just gonna play full volume on your desktop audio and you don't want that. So once you do this, you're actually not gonna hear it. But as you can see at the bottom of my mixer here, it is there and I can control the volume straight through OBS. If I do want to hear it, I believe I click on the cogwheel and then advanced audio properties. And then I find Moobird and then I go monitor only mute output, meaning that I'll be able to control the volume here, but I'll be hearing it through the desktop. So it will be appearing through the desktop audio. Okay, as you can see, if I go up here, it appears in the desktop audio, right? But I'm controlling it here. I can make it higher, lower. There you go. Now there is this visual with the browser source. Question is, what happens if you turn it off? If you hide it, it actually stops playing, right? You bring it back up, it's here. So if you don't want the visual to show, I would probably put it underneath something, for example, the camera, so it's not visible, or you can just drag it outside of the frame like this. But I think it's a pretty cool visual. Nothing wrong with it. If you want to keep it, you can do that too. Deep and low beats. I just want to listen to all of them. Okay. That's pretty nice. That is pretty nice. And what else do they have in products? So they have Moobird Studio, they have their API, Moobird Play, and that is going to be their app for the App Store, basically, where you can actually play all of that if you want to. Studio is basically going to be a software if you really want to go in depth in creating your own music. But Moobird Render is what we're focusing on today and how easy. As you can see, it saved everything that I created. I'm not even logged in. I'm not even logged in. It remembered, hey, you remember you made this? Which is pretty cool. Let's listen to what other people have made or what they already have in their library. I don't like that. Settings, fantasy, fantasy, cinematic.
Moobird.
Mubert. I love the voice saying Mubert. Anyway, so there are themes. You have a playlist here, for example. You have BPM, if you want to set the BPM. So 80 is going to be, 50 is going to be super slow. And 128 is going to be your typical house music. And then anything higher than that, maybe 140, since it's half step, like dubstep, for example. And then anything higher, like 185 is like, boo, 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 you know, hard step maybe. Or drum and bass, I guess. Very fast drum and bass. Wow. Your favorite film. Okay. I'm definitely going to be using this for my YouTube videos. But anyways, that was Mubert.com and their way of rendering music. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. If you have any suggestions or what did you like, what did you not like? I'm sure the people at Mubert will be looking at this video, so it's pretty important. Thanks again to Mubert for sponsoring this video. I had a lot of fun and I will definitely be using some of those songs for my videos, especially my long, long tutorials. They can get a little boring when they're long like that and I usually don't use any sound. So I can just generate a 25-minute track and then we're Gucci. I, of course, recommend you go check it out, play around with it, maybe create some tracks that you like, knowing that they will be original. You will be creating your original tracks in a couple of clicks. Use my link in the description. And yeah, if you want to talk to me, I'll be probably live streaming on Twitch at some point. So go follow me, twitch.tv/gallevel. But this is it for the video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you guys next time. Go out there, make me proud. Gallevel. Out.